Hey. Sound check. Ironheaded checking in already. Let me rename this broadcast. Saturday stream. Dirty sheets make skates. I missed you, dirty sheets. Oh yeah, this is back to the headset, Ironheaded. Yesterday during the hangout, we're using these two lav mics, and so it's a compromise of quality to get so two people can be heard. I gotta get like a switchboard, but that's another donation goal, because those bitches are expensive. Oh, we went to like 9, I don't know, 8:39 yesterday, Ironheaded. Banks J Twitch, what up, pimp? watching my stream on YouTube. Word. I barely made it in time. This 11 a.m. call time is hard for me. Literally just ate a pancake. Dirty sheets, McSkeets. I don't expect anything less. Let me promote the stream one time before I start it. Hit up the old face beezy. Set it over in the long war. And the hobby group. That shit. One last post. Let's go to the hobby page. Ooh, the Spiky Bits hobby page hit 10,000 people. Posted. All right, close that fucking window. Let me just check our alert box, make sure our alert box is popping off. That was good. Yo, dog, Kenny Boucher here. Next Level Painting. Hitting you up on the other literal best of all days, Saturday. We did a Friday stream. We're doing a Saturday stream? What the hell's going on here? Yesterday was an all-day hangout, though, so it's a little bit less informative, more like let's just hang out together. We worked on the Slovethian fucking tree people all day. Some terrain pieces, you know, experimenting with terrain techniques. I did get a big old brush finally, right, and I was able to bang down some Realm of Battle tables last night after the stream, looking pretty good. And of course, Friday is our studio tutorial day, and up on Patreon, you get the newest video right then. But if you're a YouTube follower and not a Patreon follower, then you got Dwarf video, because that happened like literally 3 weeks ago. So that's like the difference in schedule sometimes. But 2 weeks behind. So we just dropped the iconic Bloodthirster, the OG Bloodthirster. Let me see if I can. I'll put them on the big screen real quick for you guys. And so this Bloodthirster, now, like, don't judge me about the paint job. All right, this is not my number one paint job right here. This is what's, if you haven't seen the video, what's amazing about this paint job is this is an eBayed model, a quote unquote eBayed pro painted miniature. Now, the video chronicles me taking this model from a very horribly painted stage to this level, and you can see every detail is painted, cleanly executed. Got some nice shades on the face, some decent dry brushing work, you know, like literally, this is not how it looked though when I got on eBay. The video is an epic video. It is, you know, 20 minutes long, and it really just shows you how to make an eBay purchase based on a paint job that lets you turn the paint job into, like, you know, like, this is, you know, this is a little bit better than tabletop quality, you know what I mean? Like, there's more going on here because of the wash tech. And you can see, like, every detail's been hit, you know, like, and I bought this model because the guy had basically blocked in the colors. And we patched it up real quick on the tutorial. And I showed you, like, literally, like, yeah, you can dunk it in a container of acetone, scrub it down, and start over. Or you could do what I just did, and in, like, 25 minutes, the Bloodthirster looks like this. Boom, now you can possess some Bloodthirsters in the battlefield and not feel bad about them. So definitely check that video out if you haven't seen it. It's one of our best videos, eBay hacks. Definitely check it out. And today, obviously, we're gonna try to airbrush this piece of terrain right here. The reason we have an early call time today is I'm going up to Steal One More Name's crib, and we're gonna throw down for a guerrilla battle report, West Coast guerrilla battle report here up in California. So that's gonna be fun. And so we have plans to meet up at 5, so normally I do 2. It's a little kind of a little close, hour and a half drive, so we'll get a little airbrushing. Let me see, let me jump back into that Chizat. Anyone want to see that Q-Warner? Make sure I have the right camera engaged. I do. Got some people checking in. Dirty Sheets, Iron Headed, Big Boy Elroy, what's up, pimpin'? Dirty Sheets says, when you work graveyard shift, a 12 pack and a pint of Jack at 6 a.m. really ain't that weird. Only to 80-year-old ladies selling it to you. Big Boy Elroy, yep, refurbished model. And we're back. Ty winning in the hizzy. Iron Headed. Yeah, I mean, it should be a good one. Should be a good one. Sorry, I just forgot to mute the Twitch stream. That little sound. We're gonna be playing out of his personal collection though, so I'm not like bringing my gangster list or anything like that. We're gonna be playing I think he's gonna be playing his Raven Guard, and I'm gonna be playing Dark Angels Ally with Sisters. So should be interesting. should be a good one. You know, my mom started watching the stream. She watches it on our smart TV, makes my dad watch with her. My dad doesn't quite understand how this works. So he's like, Kenny's on TV? What? Is he an actor? And she's like, no, this is the internet. No, the internet's on your computer. This is the TV. Shit is so funny. Dirty Sheets, you're going to be at Disney with the kids October 1927. Want to get together and get a game or two during the weekend of October 22-23. So you're going to be with your kids in Hollywood, and you're just going to like, fuck it, let's play two games for fucking 12 hours in the middle of that. I mean, like, I'm down to, but like, my lady wouldn't be with that. If I were you. Cat, a couple's checking in. The mighty web ruler of the stream and the owner of his own stream. Are you guys online today, Cat a couples? Zeb? Yeah, Ironheaded. When I'm in Bad Boys 3 is an extra, then we can say I'm on TV. People keep telling me I need to try out for the Black Sails, being extra in Black Sails. APM Eastern, huh? 5 PM Pacific. I'll be off way before then. But yeah, guys, check out Catacouples. They've been doing some hobby stuff too on the side, so. I mean, if watching two hilarious individuals play video games isn't entertaining enough. All right. Girl time. Okay. So what we got is, we got a lot of fun terrain that we built over the weekend. And this is like a skull tower. This is like kind of, I think, right when GW started using computers, so it's like so ghetto. Like, I'm not gonna worry about some of these major seams on this piece of terrain, and it's hard to see because it's all gray on gray right now, but it's, you know, like, they're just big cracks. Like, I'm gonna just dry brush it up and let it ride. Like, even the GW artwork, they don't do anything about those cracks. But on the Vortex platform, this dais right here, this is a fresh piece of Age of Sigmar terrain. I did green stuff up the seam right here. This thing is going to get such a nice airbrush, like, just amazing, you know, application of paint. I don't want this seam to detract from the model, so I definitely took some time to green stuff that. You can see on this side, I didn't finish green stuffing it because if you guys want me to, I'll go over some green stuff. Now, there's better things to use in green stuff for plugging seals up. You know what I mean? But right now, all I got is green stuff in the Beats Lab. If this is something you want to see me do, if three people say I want to see it, I will green stuff this seam up for you guys. So just think about that. And I can see you guys on here. Ty Wedding says I look like a sort of like a pirate. Dirty Sheet says, my wife is shopping with the kids and doing family shit. Me and my boy, Yo Desiree, want to get some games in? Shopping? Dirty Sheet says, a butt pirate. Yep. That's insulting. Not. Yeah, the Vallejo Ironheaded, the Vallejo plastic putty is definitely the best for plugging seams. Like, you're not sculpting with it, obviously, but you're plugging seams with it real good. I just don't have any right here. It's in the mail right now. Dirty Sheets, I don't want to see it. Doesn't I don't want to see it undo I want to see it in the voting process? Alright. Well, no big deal. I'll let you guys think about it while I work on this other piece of terrain. Up, oh, the British Pete made it live, so you don't have to wait for it on Patreon. It's definitely a lot more interesting live, brother. Alright, so these skulls that we're going to work on. Now, like, the box art has them looking like stone, but a little bit more brown in there. You know, it's kind of interesting. So I think what I'm going to do is start off with a brown myself, and I think I'm going to use a P3 brown. I think I'm going to use Bloodstone. What's up, I'm the Coop? Get that Bloodstone. I'm kind of low on Flow Improver, too. I got some coming in the mail. Little Flow Improver up in the Pizzot. Dirty Sheets Mesquites. You graveyard shift working drunk. A little water. Big boy Elroy, make blood pouring out of the eyes like waterfalls. The British Pete says, looking forward to the terrain masterclass. The Calvary Brown is more red. Definitely closer to actually red than Bloodstone. Like, I love Calvary Brown, it's one of my favorite colors. Let's throw the old glove on. Actually, let me put my mask on. I'm about to talk through the mask. It's gonna get swifty in here. Yeah, Bloodstone. If you guys can still hear me. Yep. All right. Cool. Yeah, Bloodstone. Bloodstone is a good rust base. Alright, you know what? Let me raise the camera up a little bit, actually, because it's a little... Try to get that lift. Need to get a little bit further away from the skulls if we're gonna actually show some airbrushing. Tablet down. The crotch cam, aka the ball sack cam. Alright. I'm gonna back the needle out just a little bit, guys. Like, literally, like a fucking centimeter, not even. Just open it up a little bit. Let's it flow a lot better. That's one of the tricks right there when you're working on terrain. Make sure to get all the angles. And I used a really thick primer. Like, literally, like primer that you would use for radicating on cars. Real thick gray. Give it maximum protection and also add a little texture to the model. When I'm working on terrain, I'm definitely willing to use those types of primers. But no, I wouldn't use them on miniatures, though. We're gonna grab these side angles up real quick. We got a weird fuzzy piece of bullshit stuck to this guy's nose. Pulling that shit out. Alright, I'm gonna have to stand it up for just a second. There it is. Getting good coverage. The bloodstone is really just sticking to this gray really well. It's a good color. Now, I'm not really, let me see. I'll tell you what my PSI is right now. Like, it's the silver jet. It doesn't go that high. Like, put it this way. It's set to 30. The second I pull the trigger, and I hold the trigger for like this, like, for 3 seconds, it's barely doing 18 PSI. That's the silver jet that you guys see me using all the time. It's super quiet, and it never overheats, but it's a little weak. So you gotta have to be a little bit more on your airbrush maintenance, because you're not gonna have the power to push paint through the hole. But, you know, couple little tricks like backing the needle out like I just did will simulate a higher PSI for coverage. So there's some bloodstone laid down on this thing. I'm not gonna lay it down just yet because I don't want the paint to get smeared. I'm gonna set that off to the side. Pour a little water in here. We're gonna pull out. So I'm gonna pull out. Now I'm gonna go backwards in steps. Yeah, it's a super weak compressor. But like I said, I've had this compressor on running for like 9 hours before. It never overheated. So there is a trade. You know what I'm saying? Hey, Martin, what's up, pal? Missed you, homie. The British Pete. Oh, yeah, this is part of an evolving commission for the Realm of Battle Table. Get an industrial compressor. Now, I used to use a big one with a reducer on it back in my old trailer. But I find that it just doesn't matter. Like, you guys see my work, right? Like, it doesn't suck. Like, I'm doing just fine with this Awata Silverjet, man. It's a professional-grade airbrush, bro. Like, for artists. All right, so I cleaned out this pot real quick. Oh, ATCs this weekend. Can of couples. I mean, I live in fucking Hollywood, dog. Like, that's why I'm not there. Like, it's in Chattanooga, bro. I used to live in North Carolina. She was like a 6-hour drive. And that's even kind of far. This is the first year I've missed the ATCs in 6 years, since its inception. But we know Juice is there representing, Rob is there representing, holding it down with X-Wing. Absinthe checking in. All right, so I'm feeling burn umber. If I can spot my burn umber on my table, just to add a couple of dark spots to the skull. Nope. I'm not seeing it. Burn umber is hiding. Does your burn umber ever hide from you? I think that burn number is pissing me off right now. Dirty Sheets, you're gonna be going to ATC next year? God damn it. Literally have no idea what my fucking burn number is. Hey Martin, checking in. For the Bloodthirster and the Emperor, really, motherfucker? Thank you, homie. I love you. Alright, so I'm actually just, I guess, can't find burn number. No big deal. We're actually gonna go to Calvary Brown. And, gonna add just a little bit of Calvary Brown in, cause I wanna showcase the difference in colors. Oh, I wish this was burn number, but that's wash. Good looking out though. Good looking out. It's entirely possible I don't have any left. Okay, so I'm gonna pull out this Calvary Brown right here. Okay, need more water in this Calvary Brown. Calvary Brown's fucking up. Always between the blue and the yellow. Nice, Dirty Sheets. All right, Calvary Brown activated. So I'm going to sneak into these eyes with some Calvary Brown. You see how red the Calvary Brown is? Now that you have a the Bloodstone brown to showcase it near. I know it's not air. For the pigments, iron-headed, I barely use air colors because they really thin the pigments down on those air colors. It works great in an airbrush, but like that's a real fucking color. Like this Calvary Brown, like the shit you get in the airbrush, the airline, it's like a thin ass version of this. Same thing for almost every major pigment. So like all the sick pigments, I always buy the game color. And then for like the metallics and like things like burn umber and stuff like that, I'll buy the air version. You can't fuck burn umber up. Yeah, the air metals are just so glorious. Like, they're the best metals in the business. So, I'm going to do a little bit more with this Calvary Red though. This Calvary Brown. I'm gonna start dropping some highlights in, some shades in, along some of these cracks. I'm gonna get close, and be patient. Guys, see that? You see that? I'm just using this color to darken and shade some regions, and also trace the cracks to really give me some definition there. Because I'm gonna come back in with a dry brush later, so I want there to be some interesting things that the dry brush can interact with. Black metal is a great color. You like that liquid gold? There it is. It's coming out pretty good. And since these colors are clearly similar browns, you're getting a really nice transition. Just darken it up toward the bottom, real nice. It's kind of my go-to. I'm gonna let it dry for a minute because we're getting kind of aggressive with it, and we're chipping paint left and right off of it by spinning it around so much and letting it hit the ground or hit the table. So after this coat, I'm gonna let it dry for a few minutes while we work on something else. I'm gonna spray inside these nose holes. The next thing we're going to do is we're definitely going to highlight it. So we're getting a nice looking color right there. I'm feeling good about that. And we're going to come in and just progress and give it a nice subtle highlight, and then we'll dry brush the shit out of this thing. And then that'll be a good solid piece of terrain for the table. Let's set that up off to the side. Got that. And I'll work on this stupid tower here. Get this fucking green stuff seam. No more vote. It's just happening. Gonna pour back the rest of the Calvary Brown back in the pot. Shit's too good to waste. Gonna clean out the airbrush real quick because we're gonna need it again. So you definitely don't want it to be sitting there getting all dry. Turn off the compressor. Let it sit there, soak for a minute. Close up the tripod a little bit. There we go. All right. Currently looking for the lid to Calvary Brown. Because apparently I opened it and just flung the lid somewhere randomly on my workstation. And I just found burn umber. But I'm actually happy with the Calvary Brown. Apparently my tiny dog has to go potty. I wish I had an office that also wasn't the back door of my house. All right, so literally lid to burn umber, or sorry, to Calvary Brown has gone straight missing. So we're going to commandeer someone else's lid. Alright. Let's talk while we let that piece dry for a few minutes. You like the Vallejo Liquid Gold series? Dirty Sheets Mesquite, you were talking about that? Someone was asking about the airbrush. Who was that? Soren Kelper? No? What's up, though? What's up, pimp? Absent checking in. Oh, quick shout out on airbrush. And use the Awada Eclipse. Dirty Sheet says, I discovered metallics have a lot to do with the primer. That's true. We have a video on that. Like, one of the best ways to paint things gold is to paint them silver first. Yeah, Absinthe, you know what I'm talking about. Always find it. But I'm actually really happy we ended up using the Calvary Brown. It's got a real subtle transition. You know, and that means, you know, that's always more interesting in my opinion. The Lord Cypher checking in. What's up, brother? Soren Kelper, if you want, I'm sure could draw a quite few Europeans stream around 10-11 a.m. your time. Repost on social media. What would be your main thing to work on? Is that social media advice? Looks good by accident, Absinthe. I don't do anything by accident. You don't think I bought that Calvary Brown knowing that one day I would need to use it in substitution for another color? Yeah, it's definitely a trade-off, but it's Saturday. That's why the Saturday stream is... Saturday is definitely the one stream I can definitely do early. Iron-headed. Like, I'm definitely not going to be streaming 11 a.m. Tuesday anymore. Like, we started that way. That's just not smart. Not to mention we have to deal with Pacific times and East Coast times in our country. Was it between the blue and yellow? Hold on a second. Oh, hold up. There was a yellow. It was between Minotaur Black and Moon Yellow. So, close. Absinthe, I know what you meant. The whole time I'm painting Absinthe, like, look at this guy. I only watch his stream so that I can laugh at all his mistakes, knowing full well that my shit is so tight. Have you been to her Facebook page? It's literally just narcissism. AKA pictures of amazing food that she cooks and cool models that she paints, but mostly cool food. I watch her page as I'm eating a slice of pizza that I ordered with tears in my eyes. Lord Cypher, where do you live? Shout out to Jack Skellington. Hey, Martin. Oh, the mug? Is that what we're looking at? Yes, this is my go-to coffee mug. It's my jam. Still my first cup. So I'm gonna bang out this green stuff seam real quick. While we let all of this, and it's still wet in there. Let me look at the camera pulled back. I mean that's a good looking color transition in my opinion. Like, I like that. Real simple for terrain. I'm thinking, I feel like one more highlight, but I don't even know. It might be just dry brush time. It is terrain after all, and it's going to be weathered stone. So maybe I'll just let it dry, and then we'll hit it with that dry brush. You know, like for real. While that's like, we'll work on the seam. So anybody who wants to see some green stuff, it's happening. I'm sorry, Dirty Sheets Mesquites, but you're gonna have to watch this. Now, like I said, Vallejo plastic putty, which we're not using right now, is really good for seam sealing. But one of the things it doesn't do well is it doesn't sculpt, which it's not for sculpting. So you're not going to be able to feather it as much, but it is good enough that you can pretty much get it right into a seam, and it controls super, like it's super good. Like I recommend having it in your hobby station. I ran out. I have an order out right now, but we're going to use what we have. Sometimes you got to do that. I'm sure everyone knows the first part with green stuff. Get these bitches, get it looking green. Lord Cypher in China? What? Good Lord. Liquid, I am the coop. Liquid, I use liquid green stuff for the most subtle things, but at the end of the day, I've been using liquid green stuff for a while. It is garbage. Dirty Sheets is right. You have to whip it into a slurry and like get it almost like, get it like it's its own paint, and essentially paintbrush it into the seam. And then there's so much evaporation from the water that it's like you have to do it 3 or 4 times. It's very situational. You know what I find it being good for? If you ever want to add like dirty, rough, like rust patterns to things prior to painting them so it's textured, that's about what it's good for. Soren Kelper, Global, Truth, I feel you. John Bingham checking in. Sunny Sacramento, Sun. No doubt. Big Boy Elroy, hot water to get it going faster. I'm gonna use a lot of water. Don't worry. But it's already done. You just gotta use more. You gotta use that man grip, dog. You know what I'm saying? Like basically, you gotta squeeze it with the force it takes to turn coal into diamonds. There it is. So, I got a couple dentist tools I like for this. This is my go-to right here. I've used this one for years. And it has like this other slicer on the other side. But this is my favorite side right here. Now, I've never used that, British Pete. If it's anything like Vallejo plastic putty, then I'll like it. But sometimes all you have left is this roll of green stuff from 6 years ago, and you got to use it. All right, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to take this green stuff into like a long skinny strip. And I'm going to lay it over. Like that. And the dental tool that I love lets me push it into that crack pretty easily. Thank you for the host, Pimpin'. You see, and this, that really just gets it in that crack, you know? That huge seam. I'm just really just, now I'm just kind of like beating up the excess and taking it off. Just like that. That's what I like about the dental tools. I can really do some fun stuff with it. Sorry, guys. Just pull that excess off. And now you can flip the tool over and use it more like a blade and just drag the green stuff away from the seam. Just like this. And like, this is the only advantage I find to green stuff, is that now I can blend it if I need to pretty easily. Something I struggle to do with like even Vallejo putty. Oh yeah, now I didn't want it wet right there on the coupe because I wanted it to be sticky. So that it would, so as I dragged it away from the seam, it would stick to my tool and I'd be able to rip it off easier. Now I have the amount of green stuff I want here. Now I'm going to pull out some water so I can start smoothing it down without it sticking to my blade. I'm going to fill up a little pot with this water so I can use it like a paintbrush. That simple. And now, with water creating a nice, basically lubricant, so it doesn't stick to any to anything but the thing I already pressed it into, I'm just going to blend the green stuff along the natural curvature of this cyclone. Using the curved side of my dental tool. And it blends real easy. This tool is amazing. I bought it on eBay like, I want to say 7 years ago, man. I've definitely had it for a long time. It just fits into any little channel. Like, it's such a good tool. GW used to sell one like this. I mean, this is literally, I got it from a dentist office online. Like, this is legitimately a dentist tool. Surgical steel. We're almost there. And like I said, this is the one thing I like about green stuff, is my ability to blend it to blend it to match. I like that, you know. You get a real organic blend. And you can really fade, you can really just fade it out to like such thin ratios, like where now it's blending completely into the plastic, like with no transitional, no visible transitions. I'm even gonna use my finger right now because my finger is softer, just to get this to smooth that ridge down a little bit. Because we got all this water on there. We're a little thick up top right here. Smoothing it down just a little bit right here. Pretty good. So we got it. So hit that whole. I mean, this thing was like a fucking eighth inch gap all the way down. And now we've wiped it completely out. And this vortex is ready to go. Take a primer. Get airbrushed. It's a fun thing. And some dude sits on the top right here. This is a cool terrain piece right here. All right, sorry to bore you to death with that one, Dirty Sheets. Well, I'll show off the other skulls here in a second. Do a quick roll call. Quick shout out to A. Martin. $5 donation, appreciate it, brother. For the Bloodthirsters and the Emperor. Mood Honey. Do not talk that way, or you will get banned from our stream. Dental wax carving tool. A. Martin coming in hot with the name. Ironheaded, you're in New Jersey? Damn, dog, I'm sorry. You're forgiven, Mood Honey. Me Cho checking in. What's up, brother? You know what? And GW sells a lot of good tools. Like, I give them a lot of hate. The only thing I like about their tools is the price point. But they're good. You know, like, they're all useful. It's just, like, I think I bought this... this dental tool right here for like literally $4.99. I've had it for better part of a decade. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, GW's, I guarantee, was like $18. And I've just been invited to a painting group on Twitch. That sounds cool. Tell me more about it, Micho. Ironheaded. Spit. That's literally my go-to. If I'm green stuffing in my Beats Lab and I'm not on camera, there a lot of spit gets on these models. I'm not going to lie. When I'm green stuffing, obviously, I was trying to keep it classy for the stream. And anyone who tuned in yesterday to our all-day stream, thank you. It was really fun having Alan mic'd up so we can answer questions and just chill all day. We might start turning that into a semi-regular thing. Who's that Pokemon? And his name is John C. Joe Darkblade coming in hot. I haven't seen you before, Joe Darkblade. Not donating, at least. Thank you for the $5 donation. He simply says, you rock, dog. No, you rock. But we are trying to turn what we did on Friday, me and Alan, into a semi-regular occurrence. He's officially my subcontracted assembler for a little while at least. Like, I mean, I'm going to have work for him for a while. I got some contracts out. So, you know, he lives in Los Feliz. He's doing the Hollywood thing. You know, he's PAing right now. He just did a feature. He's doing his thing. He's, you know, we've known each other for a long time, though, almost 10 years. And he just happens to be out here, too, now. And so, in between gigs, like, he's looking for coin. And, like, I don't have to tell you guys, like, I think he's renting, like, one bedroom in an apartment in Los Feliz for, like, $1,300. Like, that's the best rates you can get out here. So, he's like, so money helps. But he only has one room. So, like, building in his Beats Lab, building my Beats Lab, same thing. So, I was like, let's just be building my Beats Lab and let's film it. And now, I'm going to get a switchboard, guys. Like, I'll put it up in a donation goal soon. So that way we can do, like, two USB mics instead of, like, the shitty lav mics. I bought those in a pinch so that we both can be heard. And obviously, there was a lot of, like, quality manipulation to get the noise gate right. But good experiment. We're going to try to do it every couple of Fridays. Friday hang. So that way, Friday tutorial drops. Then Friday, we model all day, you know, do our things. Hey, Martin, are you getting sassy on me? I will paint this vortex for you guys, I promise. I won't paint this and then come back to a stream with it already painted. I will paint this on stream. Just not right now, obviously. I want the green stuff to harden, then I want to prime it. I will paint this for you guys. We're going to do some serious airbrushing on this vortex. You know what I'm saying? It's going to be fucking amazing. We've got all the cool terrain for this set. Joe Darkblade, first time catching you live. Been enjoying your show for a while, though. Thanks, man. You watch it on YouTube? You watch it on Patreon? Let me know, man. Big boy Elroy, that's $1,300 with a roommate, dog, where you share a bathroom. That's not even... it's brutal out here. I mean, it's because... there's the SAG building right here, and they want everyone to be 40 miles away from the SAG building to do productions out here. It saves a lot of money. So, guess what that means? Everyone wants to live 40 miles away from the SAG building, so that's why we have millions of people right here. And because of that, it drives the cost up. YouTube, no doubt. Joe Darkblade, just so you know, you sent me a $5 donation. I truly appreciate that. But for $6 a month on my Patreon page, you get access to everything you see on YouTube weeks in advance with no commercials and more bonus content. So I just want to put that in perspective. But I truly appreciate it. Yeah, I mean, there's other places in... there's other places that are a lot more reasonable out here, Absinthe, though. But if you're in the industry, like, and you got to be right where we are, like, the further away from, like, Hollywood you get, the more difficult it is to work. All right, let me take a look at the skulls we were working on. So this is what we started the show with. Quick two-stage airbrush on these skulls. Sorry, guys. Let me raise the tripod again. Alright, so we started the show with these skulls. Two-toned airbrush, that's simply Bloodstone from P3, and then followed up with a little shading with Cavalry Brown. Now, these are supposed to be kind of a stony brown, so I feel good about this. We're probably... It's a little light, you know what I mean? So, bear with me. I'm gonna matte varnish this motherfucker real quick. Alright? I'm gonna Matt Varnish this motherfucker real quick, so that he's protected. I might even hit him with a semi-gloss, just to have more protection. So bear with me for 1 minute while I do that, because I am gonna, like, I'm giving myself a solid another hour on the stream minimum before I boost out to do that Gorilla Battle report. So what I'm gonna do is, and you know, I got other things in my Beats Lab we can do. So let me do that real quick, because I do want to dry brush this guy for you. And I'll show off the Rumba battle table we did yesterday. 1 second. Funny, I was just complaining about the how I wish my office wasn't also the back door of my house. I forgot about the most convenient part about that was that I can just prime right out there. And so I left the skull out there baking in the sun for a minute or two to speed up the dry time. It's not very humid here in California right now, so not too worried about it. Jazar, what up, pimpin? Quick $5 donation. Says, I gotta pay that rent. Yo, man. If only I can, like, show you guys my books so you can understand the plight. How poor I actually am to rent ratio. Don't go to the light, I am the coop. Dark Joe Darkblade, sign up after the show. Totally worth it. Appreciate it, man. It is worth it. Like, most people would say, hey, my Patreon page is totally worth it. I say it from a place of, if you're here watching it and you find the content relevant anyway, I work my butt off to make sure the Patreon page has content to justify, you know, the investment. Dirty Sheet, semi-gloss. Yep, it's a semi-gloss, so it's like a satin, so I won't need to mat it back down. Somebody's talked about, sorry, I got distracted. Dalen, rest in peace, Kenny. Got abducted. Aston says, yeah, it was pretty convenient. My house is surrounded by trees, and they're always, shedding something. Varnishing outdoors is at least close to the house isn't an option. Damn. Jazzer, nah, man, you ain't lying. There's a reason most people aren't full-time commission painters. It's hard to make a living. The only reason I can do, the only way I was able to get my leg up in this industry was because for years, for like 6 years, I was a subcontractor, construction worker, pouring concrete, doing flat work, you know. And so I kind of set my own hours, worked when I wanted to work. I mean, obviously, if someone says, I need you to work this week, you know, you can't just say no. But for the most part, I was able to say, oh, I'm not available, I'm available. And then over time, and you make pretty good money in concrete. Like, a lot of people don't realize, like, if you're a good flat worker, like, you know how concrete works, like, you can make bank. You have to make, like, $250, $300 a pour, you know, like. And me and my crew, we can pour a slab in, like, 3 hours. So, like, we were doing it. We were like lining up two pours, doing it five times a week. We're making good money. But at the same time, that gave me like a cushion and an ability to say I'm not available this week. So as I transitioned to pro painting, I was able to like, all right, let's paint this army in 2 weeks. Hey, boss, I'm not available for 2 weeks. And then I had it lined up enough people where eventually I can't work for 2 weeks became I can't work for months, to the point where I still haven't had to go back to concrete, and it's been almost 7 years. But not everyone has a job like that, and also they don't live in a trailer. Like, I lived in a trailer I bought for, you know, like literally my lot rent was $300. Like, so I didn't have overhead, didn't have bills, didn't have kids. Like, so that it was kind of a, like, basically I took a look at my life and I was like, at this moment in your life, if you don't make the transition into finally being successful at some business you tried to start because you failed at every other business, like, you, if you don't do it right now, you're never going to do it. So here we are. In October this year will be our 7 year anniversary at Next Level Painting. The British Pete says, the Patreon page is amazing value. I've enjoyed it ever since I appreciate it, homie. Now you can make green stuff, Iowa's Ironheaded says. Yeah, Mudani, you're right. No more concrete. I ain't trying to do that. Ain't about that life anymore. Big boy Elroy, kids ruin everything. God, they do. Ugh. Thunderflux, what sort of commission do you enjoy the most? Well, that's hard to say, you know, because I'm a professional now, like, and I think in the beginning, I would, like, paint armies and be like, damn, I wish I had this army. I really wish I, you know, like, it was a lot different in the beginning, and now I approach every task very detached, like, these are my models, and they'll never be my models. And once I did that, I think I was able to do a better job. You know, like in the early days of Next Level Painting, if you go to my Picasa, I think you can still log in, you can see real old galleries that I don't even show on my page anymore. Shit, that's embarrassing compared to what I do now. But I've always been a better painter than my gallery showed. But when you figure out your pro painting formula, you know, you gotta have to compromise some quality. You have to find that marriage of quantity and quality, which is like the Next Level Painting process. Back in the old days, it was literally like, airbrush these models, throw some wash on these models, airbrush them again, throw some trim on these models, little bit of wash there, good, GG. Over time, like I talk about challenging yourself as a painter, when someone's like, "Why I'm not going to highlight all those edges, that's ridiculous." Well, that's what I used to say. And then over time, as I got so fast at my process of like, paint the trim, wash, then I was like, okay, like on this project, let's just also paint little tiny highlights on the shoulder pads. That is it. Then on the next project, after I'd done a whole project that way, and I got fast, and I just incorporated it into my speed, into my natural level, I was like, let's also do this piece. And then over time, that's just how I paint. So here we are 7 years later, and I just highlight everything now. But that was a leveling process. And even now, the stuff I show you guys on my stream, with little bit of exception, like the Yuzhing and the Pano are real good. Like, that's a lot closer to what I actually can paint. Most stuff you see come through my gallery is not like me trying to win awards. It's me implementing an artistic process that I've developed. You know what I mean? It's very cost inefficient to actually put down your A game 100% on a model. So when you have the luxury of working with a client that wants you to put down your A game, then you get to do like what I've done with the Yuzhing. The Yuzhing was literally like, Optimus Stein said to me, bring it. I don't care how long it takes, you know? And so I brought it, you know? So that, I mean, that's like in a nutshell, like anyone trying to be a pro painter, like those are the kind of things you have to balance as you go through life. Okay, a couple. Probably gonna be streaming for another solid hour, maybe longer. Dirty Sheets, McSkeets. So edge highlighting is so dead to me. I hate it. You know what I mean? I still mean that. But if someone's paying you dollar bills, you got to do it. You know what I mean? And that's why I used to turn down commissions that were like edge highlighting was like the linchpin of the commission back in the day. Because I said, hey, I don't do it. Well, then over time, you start losing work. That's what brought me to my belief of like, well, I need to start implementing this into my rhythm so I do it without, you know, taking up more time than is appropriate so I can be efficient. And then now I don't turn away edge highlight commissions. But yo, you ain't gonna catch me edge highlighting a bunch of Raven Guard for my personal army. Like, so I guess to answer Thunderflux question with all of that bullshit I just spit, the commissions I enjoy the most are based on client interaction, not models. When a client gives me leave to do what I do, that will always become my favorite commission. I'm gonna show you guys what we did with the Realm of Battle. All right. See if we can show some of this off. So you can see here are our craters right here. Came out real good. Skulls looking good in there. Good, nice little dry brush. And we're going to put some secret weapon water effects in there, or Vallejo water effects. Actually, secret weapon's my favorite. So we're going to backfill it with secret weapon. And we did get our dry brush to look the way we wanted to on this, utilizing a synthetic soft bristle, like house painting brush, getting nice strokes. And the brown patches are cavalry brown with a little orange brown highlighted on top. The rest of it is that shadow gray with basically a color match to men off white base, like the bone. And now the trick to these tablescapes is, so you want there to be some kind of texture that breaks up the uniformity. So that's where the brown spots come in. The brown spots also match all the bases we did for the dwarves. So that way, anywhere the dwarves are, colors are going to match. The trick to Realm of Battles, though, is you can't ever have the brown, any of your patches, go extend beyond the edges. Because then that means you only have one way that you can put the table together. That means, like, if the brown is going here and it just stops on this tile, it looks stupid. So you have the brown always has to be in the center of the tile. And you can't let, and like I'm going to have to come in and touch it up, but you can't let, for example, like you see this edge highlighting right here, how it's clipping the edge, and now we have like a perfect little line. We're going to have to take that off, because when you line the tiles up, you're going to see these perfect lines. These are the things you have to think about when you're doing tile terrain. You can't have that, you know, because then it looks weird as you mix and match the tiles. But so this is what, this is all, like I said, some cool airbrushing, some washing in the cracks, fun dry brushing. This is all very simple stuff, and you can get a real dynamic, you know, cool effect. And this is like the least interesting tile. Wait till we get to the ones with the hills and the rocks on them. I find it fitting that we're doing terrain now. Big boy Elroy. No, I do. I plan on putting a little red in between the skulls, a little red ink. Let that dry. Then you put the clear water in there, and it'll look like blood. It's better to do that. Thanks, Ironheaded. Right out of beer, dirty sheets, mesquites. Spithy, excuse me. Spithy says that the craters look three-dimensional. That was the effect that we were going for with the airbrush. We really wanted to make them look like just real solid, just, you know, incredible pieces, you know, like... Yep, and that's what's cool is that GW's coming out with the terrain. Warhammer TV's doing a bunch of terrain tutorials. Now we are. You know, GW at one point just realized they're going to need to hire me, put me in the studio, get Duncan out of there. I like Duncan. I'm just teasing. Drizar reminds me of the old custom tables GW would do for Games Day each year. All right, let me go check on those skulls outside, guys. A tile like this, Soren Kelper, I recommend going to Home Depot and buying like the most gangster varnishes, because those are designed to be like on, you know, like outdoor furniture and shit. So get one of those like real hardcore ones that's like three times the coverage. Yeah, you'd probably be all right just hitting it once. Duncan is good though. Like, some of the things he paints are phenomenal. Like, don't get me wrong, like, Duncan is talented, yo. And they put on a real good production at Warhammer TV, like a production that I can't touch right now, like, because I don't have multicam and camera operators, and like, I don't have the luxury just painting and have somebody else edit it for me, you know what I mean? But yeah, that, you know, but he is, it's like, where's his energy? That's my big problem with Duncan. Like, Duncan is informative. He lays down the facts, but like, he never gets passionate about like what he's painting, and that to me is like a turnoff, especially when you're like, you work for the company that makes these models. Get that energy level. All right, I'll be right back with the skulls. Sorry for all the headset banging around. That's just what happens. All right. This thing is nice and baked. Like, that sun baked this seal coat on. Little semi-gloss. And now we're going to dry brush it. Soren Kelper, you're welcome. Yo, man, I've been saying GW needs to hire us for a long time. The long war. No, Sore Kelper, like, you're right. Like, you get so much more. Like, that's like, why don't they have just a live stream? Like, Warhammer TV should be a Twitch channel, too. You know what I'm saying? And they disable all their comments on YouTube and everything. It's like, I understand it, but it's like, they do what they do. Like, I could be, like, I mean, like, half of what I do with the Long War is, like, I produce and direct, help develop characters. Like, I mean, dog, like, just get me on the phone with Duncan for, like, 20 minutes and I can help his show. You know what I mean? Well-spoken, well-mannered, good-looking, got all the tools. He's missing the one thing. He's missing the energy. Like, okay, this Beetle model is the dopest thing I've ever seen. Like, you know, like, how come he didn't say that one time? You know what I mean? When he was painting it. Big boy Elroy, Duncan saying yo dog. I'll start saying his things if he starts saying mine. All right. I don't know if we need the big brush on this. It might be overkill. I don't think I'll get the control I want. So I'm going to use this brush right. I'm going to use this other brush right here. And I got a t-shirt that's laying around the Beats Lab that I've been using for a paint rag. Do I have it? There it is. Got it. Ancient Chinese technique right here I'm about to show you guys. You know, I really like Angel Heraldis, and we have briefly entertained the idea of linking up and talking some live stream together. So, I would love to collaborate with Angel. Electric Eve on stream is the girl that we've seen on the Warhammer TV sometimes. She doesn't work for G-Dubs anymore, huh? Dirty Burger 88. I like everything you said in there except that first thing. Let's try not to use those types of phrases. But I appreciate the I love fedoras, but I've been banned from wearing them because you can only have one hat per crew. Yeah, Angel is amazing. It's okay, Dirty Burger. Basically, when you're live, try not to use anything that's that, you know, like anything that's like that type of connotation, you know? There's like basically like a power of five words that I will never say in my vocabulary ever again once we started doing a podcast 3 years ago. And we keep a tight community here. So far, no one in our, Nightbot has never had to ban anybody, only had to boot Ironheaded a couple times for fighting with Nightbot. Karn, I'm super happy to hear that she's streaming. I need to go support her stream. I need to look. I love Twitch, guys. I watch other people's streams all the time. Such a different feeling on Twitch than you get when it's just all YouTube and shit, you know? So, okay, here's the trick. Here is my dollar store fake bone white. This is my color match to, it's a shade between, let me show you. So here's Men Off White Highlight that I use. and I use Men Off White base right here. It's like basically in between these two. The perfect color for this. Basically, I'm going to pour some out of my desk over here off on the side. And let me get that. I might need to raise the camera up. Sorry, we're not using the detail lens. There's no way I can use a model this big with the detail lens or the detail tripod. All right. Dry brushing 101. I'll show you. I'll go to the crotch cam real quick for you guys. Here is a random t-shirt in my lap. I'm going to use this for my dry brushing palette. And we're using the same color, same browns for the most part, same bone for all the highlighting on the terrain. And I'm going to just start focusing down real light pressure first on the skull. And I'm going to go up like this to catch the bottom of that brow ridge. And I'm going to just kind of start going every way. Once most of the paint is being taken off the brush, I feel empowered to go crazy, go fucking beast mode. Like so. And I'm going to hit every surface because there's all these cracks. That's going to look good against the grain on these cracks. Just like so. Not bad. Getting some nice definition here. Turn the light down a little bit. And the cool thing is, since I used a real heavy primer, like a real thick primer, it's kind of textured it by itself now. Enough to catch a lot of this dry brushing. We're gonna keep it going. Crotch cloth, dry brush technique. Moving over to the other skulls. So I'm going to come through when it's thick on my brush and just give all this like brow ridges and stuff the meat and potatoes of the paint, so they're real exciting. Dry it off a little bit more and then start going a little buck wild. Like I said, we want these cracks to look good. Creating this stone tower of skulls. Some interesting brown transition. Sorry for going so beast mode on the camera right there. Interesting transition with browns using our bone highlight technique to really make them more interesting. It's a lot more interesting than using another brown. And now I'm using the flat of the brush to really just blend some more of this bone color into the flat surfaces. Gonna load up the brush one more time. Last set of skulls. Dry the brush off a little bit more. Start going beast mode. Just like that. Easy. Terrain 101. We have a terrain video up on Patreon right now. Did some hills. I'm going to keep doing some videos like that for a little while. And now you can go as crazy as you want with the airbrush, now that you've got all this cool dry brushing done. And I'll show you here. And the top of this right here, there's actually a bunch of bullshit, like chairs and... like, we got chairs and shit up here, and like all sorts of stuff. I'll do that later. I'll paint all this stuff on the top by hand, like a dark gray, and dry brush it, so it's two different types of stone. Okay, so I'm going to pull the airbrush out again, guys, and show you a couple cool techniques. Let's let this dry brush pigment just chill for a minute. I'm going to wash off my dry brush. And here's a quick tip. Never leave your brushes in the water. Flip them bitches upside down. Turn that light down because it's looking a little more extreme on camera than it really looks in real life. All right. Let's interact. Also, quick shout out. A. Martin coming in clutch with a donation. Appreciate that. Joe Darkblade and Drazzer. I really appreciate it, guys. The donation money is huge. And let me post this link right here, Ironheaded found for us. This is the link to the other channel. I wish I knew her name. Lady from Warhammer. Electric Eve. Looks like she does 3 days a week right now. Share the love. Emma, thank you. Ironheaded, that's a good question. Probably not going to wash the school tire. I'm not going to lie. I'm probably going to lean on a lot of airbrushing for it. I'm the coop. He's dry brushing skeet blanket. Oh, they did. I did notice that. I watched one of her videos where she painted an orc or something. Nah, maybe not an orc. I can't remember. But yeah, she was using like all of Duncan's terminology. I was like, this is lame. And she got into the commission game, so like they fired her, I bet. Poor thing. Well, they probably don't pay enough. That's probably the truth. Can't imagine though. I mean, like, yo, it's not like we're getting rich as commission painters. It doesn't make sense that they couldn't just cover that wage gap. Pull out the airbrush right now. First thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pull out some black. No, actually, I think I'm gonna do the highlight first. So I'm gonna get Men Off White highlight ready to go. In the old airbrush. I already showed you guys the Gangster Gumbo plenty of times, so... I'm probably gonna do the cracks iron-headed by hand. I probably am gonna, like, come in and do the, do some dark wash in the cracks. I'm just not gonna wash the whole thing. All I care about is the cracks in the skulls, you know what I mean? Let Like, I find that it creates more work for me. All right, so real quick. We got our highlight color and our airbrush, Menoth White highlight, and I'm gonna focus on like some of the peaks on these skulls. And just give them a real subtle highlight. Just like that. A little bit on the cheek. Just like that. Nothing crazy, you know what I'm saying? Oh, I'm back the needle out just a little bit, got a little clog. This is just going to help us get a fun little transition, you know, like remind you that these are skulls. Real simple. I think on some of these cracks, I might even go center highlight on some of them. Like that. And sometimes when you're painting a model, like the technique just starts figuring itself out as you go. And that's, I'm kind of liking that. Just like that. And I'm coming back over to where we started. I'm going to add a little bit in to some of these cracked regions like we talked about. Just like that. Real simple, okay? I'm gonna let that sit. I'm gonna dump out our excess. I'm gonna go black now and do some fun stuff. I lost the chat right quick. Soren Kelper, that's a standard next level painting move. Real thin airbrush over some dramatic dry brushing to help blend it back in. So now we're gonna take our flow improver. We're gonna use a little bit of Minotaur Raven Black. Now, you know, you guys know I don't like really particularly like Minotaur, but I do like the Raven Black. It's one of the only colors I like. Okay, thinning down this black to a nice level. So now, I'm gonna go in those eyes with some black and really darken them up, right in there. Get in the nose. Fuck that one up just a little bit, but no big deal. Just like that. Thank you. Simple stuff, guys. Ty went in. What up, pimp? What are you saying? You LOL your fave? Calling me out on something? All right. So now that I had the blackout, I'm going to thin it down just a little bit. And I'm going to try to do some fun streaks in some areas. So like up here toward the top, real thin. Oh, this is almost all air, just a little bit of paint. And I'm kind of following these cracks just a little bit. You see what's happening? Get up under this skull right here. Fade it out. Kind of help outline these skulls just a little bit. Let's follow these cracks. Real light application, guys. Like I said, almost all air. And now what we're doing is just sharpening the contrast. Just like that. And it's real thin, so it's not undoing our dry brush. Like I said, it's very thin down black. Just cutting in these skulls. Just follow those cracks. Real thin. Same thing up here. Just like that. Flip it upside down. Catch any spots you missed when you were cutting into some of these areas. I'm going to come in under the noses in some areas and darken it up. Okay. Let me dump out the black. Clean the airbrush real quick. I'll show off the model. That's some ancient Chinese techniques right there, guys. Airbrushing isn't about just saying, here's the dark color, let me transition to the light color. It's a back and forth process, and it's about deciding when a color needs to be thick, when it needs to be thin, how you want them to interact with each other. Getting that next level in airbrushing is a lot more than just, you know, orange to yellow to white to, you know, for like how we did the Yujing. That's a very easy way to airbrush, and that way works. But when you're thinking about things like terrain that, you know, rocks that don't have like traditional colors and transitions, you can kind of go nuts, man. That's what I love about airbrushing. Soren Kelper, I'm still using the Awada Silverjet, like that's probably 18 PSI, you know, maybe. Best case scenario. You know, I prefer more PSI, but I prefer my Silverjet literally not overheating even one time in 2 years. That makes me real happy. All right, here we go. So this is what we got. This is what that system that we just did. I mean, that's a great looking piece of terrain. Look how much definition we got out of that. And if you want, you can come in yet again with a lighter, with a smaller brush, and reinforce some of the dry brushing with a little bit of pure white. And now we're, and then we can paint this top right here. We'll paint all this dark gray, maybe even black to begin with. Dry brush that all up, hit all these little bricks by hand, and give it some real definition as this guy sits on top of this tower in his like gold throne. All right, let's talk. I might need to get a new cup of coffee soon up in here. Dumba checking in. What's up, player? Working on some terrain together, guys. Dumba, is this your first non-all-day hangout stream? Ironheaded. Skipping edging of the skull cracks. Oh yeah, I'm not gonna fucking edge highlight the skull cracks. It's terrain, son. but you can see there is a bit of a highlight there from the dry brushing. You see what I'm saying? Like it's enough for terrain. A green brick element. Ooh, Castle Grayskull. Oh my god. Oh my god, that is definitely happening. What's up, Dumba? Now, this is our normal tutorial stream. Working on some, you know, we've been airbrushing all morning. We did a little green stuff work with everybody. But you guys see what I'm saying is like, we started with a medium brown. We started with Bloodstone. I'll show you guys. We started with this P3 color right here, Bloodstone. Then we darkened that color with Cavalry Brown, which is a darker color right here. And Cavalry Brown is also a little red. So then we came in there and just did some shades with that. No big deal. You know what I'm saying? Then we dry brushed the whole thing with bullshit fucking dollar store fucking antique white. Then we airbrushed back in some brighter bone. And then we fucking airbrushed in some black. Like, we did all sorts of weird things. We just, all we did was create more contrast, intensify the image. You know what I'm saying? And like I said, I'll do another little light dry brush and so, and like with some of that highlight color in some of these regions. Real subtle, though, instead of like beast mode. Over some of these cracks and stuff like that. And even, and I'll show you real quick. I'll do this just real fast. I think known gloss do the trick here. Known gloss, that might be fun to try, the known oil gloss coat. Let's see how this looks. So, if you this is like definitely what I was talking about. Like I'm not gonna like paint these cracks multiple times. What I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna put some wash in them, like that. Like, this is what I'll do, you know? Just real subtle. And like I said, I can see it. The dry brushing definitely caught the edges of these cracks. So all they need is to be darkened a little bit. And then the gloss wash is flowing pretty nice. Look at that. And that's basically all you got to do to make this thing look good. I wonder, it's hard to get this angle on camera. Right there. Looks good, right? And the gloss wash really flows, so it makes this real easy. It's like the opposite of painting. Does that answer your question? Does that make you happy, Ironheaded? Just like that. That simple. And, you know, we've been streaming for like an hour and 48 minutes. And we almost finished. Look how much work we did on this piece of terrain. Like, that's not, and that's like taking breaks, talking, you know, interacting, doing Twitch. Like, that's not a hard thing to paint. The gloss washes are so money. They're so money. You know? Let me look at something real quick. I have a new idea. Let's see. How gangster do we want to get? I'm wondering. All right, I'm gonna go balls out. I'm gonna try it. Here's what I'm thinking now. I wonder how easy this is gonna be. In the teeth. Since the gloss wash really flows, look at that. Bring these teeth back. Yeah, it's like with the gloss wash, it's like, why edge highlight things when you can just do this instead? Boom. That's not bad, huh? Boom. That's the shit right there. So easy. Yep, that looks dope. Okay. I'm gonna let that dry for a minute. Quick shout out. I have no real donation goal in mind. That's why I put Infinite Bloodthirsters down there. It'll probably be a switchboard next, will be what I buy after the graphic card, which is in the mail. To really improve our stream operation with better USB headset opportunities and stuff. I use 100% of donations to fund this channel. And I use 100% of donations for what I say I'm going to use them for. If I say I'm going to buy some pizzas with them and some drinks with them, you best believe that's what I'm doing, you know? AKA tonight, I'm going to get iced. But quick shout out to Drezar, Joe Darkblade, A. Martin. Appreciate it, homies. You guys make this happen for me. The British Pete, would you stick it on a flat bit of sheet for a base when finished? That's a good idea. You know, I'm gonna ask my client, because I mean, I'm not gonna do it for free. You know what I'm saying? If it's what he wants, that's easily accomplished. That's a really good point. I'm gonna put that in the queue. The viewpoint, but the teeth doesn't look like the cracks with the wash. Well, the cracks are real deep. The teeth are very subtle. So I just try to darken them up for some definition. Just real something, just, you know, experimentation. But look at the difference. Like, so cracks looking fresh, pow, cracks will blacken them. That simple. Looking fresh, I'm happy with that. And we'll go through and we'll do all the dark cracks here in a second. Just taking a quick break. I might actually boost down and grab some coffee real quick. Karn, so you're coming to LVL. You should enjoy it. It's a really good convention. Yeah, I'm going to LVL 2017. Bringing some orcs. Joe Darkblade. Thanks, brother. Regs 6 checking in. Give me 1 minute, guys. I'll be right back. I need a cup. Sorry guys, I can't fucking do a morning with one cup of fucking coffee. Alright. Need that switchboard. Javier just jumped in. But look at him, because our plans are Long War LLC. Anybody who only watches like what I do, it doesn't know about the Long War. That's our video on demand, battle reports, hub, tactics videos, literally everything. We actually do community outreach there. We link up with other YouTube channels, get videos from them to introduce them to the audience. We want to bring streaming to Warhammer 40K, but not boring. We talked about it yesterday a little bit. Got a lot of things that we're working toward. Some exciting new ideas on how to stream Warhammer 40K games in a way that's entertaining. And we used to do them. We used to do them on Google Hangouts back in the day. And even then, you know, you're like, really, you know, you're really proud of like all these moving parts, and you get a video streamed, and you're like, shit, it's boring. I can't even watch it, you know. So we are making moves. It's for Adepticon next year, because we will be hosting another doubles tournament, bringing hobby back. Social is what we call it. And we're gonna be doing. We're gonna try to upgrade our stream game. Syntha 47. Can you repeat why he used the gloss nut oil instead of the regular one? Because it's way fucking better, dude. The regular nut oil is dead to me, son. It basically, since it's a gloss medium, the surface tension is like greatly reduced, and it flows into the cracks you want to. And also, if you ever get it on the color area you don't want it to be, which you might want it to be there, it flows away and doesn't distort the colors. It's an amazing wash. It just, only problem is it dries shiny as fuck, so you have to mat it back down. I'll get back to this here in a second. Just taking a quick coffee break. Please bear with me. Waking up at 11 a.m. or sorry, waking up at like 9:30 a.m. to get my shit ready for this is not the normal next level painting protocol. But Javier, thanks for checking in. I didn't see you today yet. You like the Bloodthirster video on Patreon? Patreon, well, we got the tiles. Like, so if you look underneath the stream window, the channel window, you'll see all these little tiles and all these little informations. Patreon is a crowdfunding page. It's a lot like Kickstarter, except it's like every month. It's like a monthly tip jar where you crowdfund through multiple people who donate small amounts of money every month. It's like a reoccurring payment. It's totally secure. And that way, artists are able to create art and not worry about being businessmen as much. And we're able to offer rewards very similar to Kickstarter. Currently, the rewards are very simple. You get to see all my studio tutorials that go to YouTube. You get to see them 2, maybe even 3 weeks early. And you get to see them ad-free forever for $6, literally just $6 a month. There's other price tiers where we give monthly subscription boxes away to people and everything like that. But you get to see videos before anyone else. You get to see them ad-free. You get to see anything you missed on Twitch there ad-free. And you get to see some of the battle reports that I edit every week. You get to see those ad-free. Our weekly webcast and our unedited after-hours podcast recordings. You get to see all those. Nobody gets to see those except Hall of Veteran people. Iron-headed. Yeah, that's the future Florax combo. Like, there's almost no reason anymore. Like, people ask me, like, oh, make your own wash. No, man, like, the wash game is so legit now. Like, I'm not interested in making my own wash. I mean, if you're looking for the stains, it's all about stains. Do you want the colors of your model to be stained by the wash or not? That's what it comes down to. If that is the effect you want, don't use the gloss wash. The gloss wash will get into the cracks, flow into them without fucking up your colors. And especially if you combo that with a gloss varnish, so it's like double. It's like basically painting on glass, you know? Goes right into the cracks, dries there, doesn't fuck with your colors. It's the truth. If you want to do a one-time donation of $100, Dumma, do it here. Don't do it on Patreon, because Patreon is reoccurring. It's a reoccurring crowdfunding. That's what it's for. It's like viewed as a subscription. It's like Netflix. Like, you're giving me X amount of dollars a month for the access that you want at the price tier that you choose. We don't have a $100 price tier. You would be wasting. I mean, we do, honestly. We have a subscription box. If you want the subscription box and you want to donate $100 a month, I'll give you like tons of minis and shit every month. Like, to offset that, like, that's one of our price tiers. It typically, most people go in at $50, though, not $100. Dumma, yes, $100 each month would be fantastic. But but I don't want you to, like, click on something that you thought was a one-time donation, and then, like, the next month have $100 be removed from your account and be like, what the fuck? Someone lied to me. Like, that's some shady business practice. I don't lie to people. But there is a cool price tier. Like I said, we have the subscription box. We got a few people, I think, even in this channel who do that. You know, where I basically take Patreon's fees out and shipping out, and I take the remainder in retail value, MSRP, and I try to basically stuff that shit in a box and send it to you every month. Like, hobby supplies, etc. It's not the main focus of our channel, but it is a cool little thing that I let some people want to do, you know, as an extra reward. All right, guys, enough promoting how you can give me money. Despite what it may appear, we actually, here at Next Level Painting, we don't do it for money. It just takes money to do this. And so I'm going to get back to the thing that we love to do, which is paint. I think all artists would agree with me on that subject. I don't do art to get paid. I just need stupid money to pay fucking electric bills and shit. Okay, let's keep working these cracks in. And as I work these cracks in, I'm sure I'll come up with new cool things to do on the model. Ancient Chinese technique, flipped upside down base, pour some of the non-oil in it. All right, I'm gonna try to keep painting this guy upside down for you guys. And I find it's really easy to draw straight lines when you're pulling to yourself. When you can brace yourself. And I find the opposite is true with the airbrush. Going away from you is how I like to create nice little straight lines with the airbrush. Real simple stuff. Now we're getting a little bit more aggressive with the wash as we understand how it interacts with the model. And the flow improver, you can definitely manipulate it. If you put too much down, you can move it around. Get these cracks. Gotta be careful with these weird ones that curve. Gotta get braced. These cracks are fun, all the spider webs. I like that. And this is barely a crack right there. Looking pretty good. There's a little hairline crack I didn't see right here. Just like that. Along the side too. Another little crack. Let's connect this little network of cracks together. Just like that. Come down to the teeth. Get these teethers. Skulls are one of my favorite designs. Get some of these cracks on this side over here. Right there. Pretty happy with that. I'm gonna let that just dry for a second because I don't want to keep spinning it around and like wiping off the undry wash, you know what I mean? So I'll let it dry for just a minute, like 90 seconds maybe, I don't know. Seeing some movement in the chat. I Absinthe agrees with me on the whole artist thing. Karn, I don't know what the fuck you're thinking if you're buying your watch directly from GW. Like, there's many people who have 20% discounts online. GW got paid. They're the manufacturer and the distributor, the primary distributor to the distribution companies. Getting 20% off does not affect their sales. They already got paid. Get your 20% discount. Go online, search it out. That's minimum. If you have a business, like an IEN number or anything like that, go to a distributor. You know what I'm saying? If you have a business, yo, ain't nothing stopping you from getting a fucking distribution license or a retail license. Ironheaded, you know what I'm talking about. Push the airbrush for lines. If you're ever doing like cool rush streaks, always get it in a position where you can go away from you. Get a nice tapered line. British Pete, God, wine drinking Brits. You guys don't drink? Never mind. As I think about it, you guys obviously don't drink whiskey. You drink pints, lagers and stuff. Karn, 20% off is still too much money. That's why I'm saying at least 20% off. I can't tell you exactly the rules here, but I'm sure Ironheaded can PM you or somebody. I don't know if you have an if you have an IEN number or anything. Whatever you do, there's distributors out there. You can get like 40% off if you're a business. You might do some retail. You know what I'm saying? Do a little investigating. Karn, for sure you can make a lot of wash to last a long time. I've been doing this professionally for 7 years. I have never fucking made a wash that's better than GW gloss wash. I've also, before GW gloss wash, I never made a wash that was better than like Secret Weapon soft body black, and before that like Vallejo dark sepia. You know, like, I mean, These amazing washes, but you're paying for them. But there's ways to get discounts, and there's a lot of headache that's removed. Ironheaded, I have a whole fucking thing I can say about that. And buying from local game stores, support them. Look, let me put it this way: if fucking game store doesn't have a discount reward program, like, let them know that they're fucking up by not buying from them. Like, no, that's on them. Like, the internet has said everything's 20% off. If you have a brick and mortar store and you don't have a rewards program that somehow equals 20% off, in a, like, for example, every $100 you spend in the store, you get $20 in $20 cash back in store credit that you can use on the same purchase. First off, when have you ever gone to a game store and not spend $100? That's 20% off. That's 20% off. You could actually store in your account and get 40% off the next purchase. You know what I mean? Like, that's a standard brick and mortar practice that I know many stores you practice. Like, if your local store is literally like MSRP on all GW all the time, and they're like, damn, you know, we can't afford to hire employees in here. I don't know what's going on. It's because everyone's buying their shit for 20% off online. British Pete. And that is whiskey, not piss weak, whiskey with an E. You're going to tell me Wild Turkey? Bourbon, America's contribution to the whiskey world? You're going to tell me that's some weak shit? I'm sorry, we all can't be hardcore and drink tea. Okay, some of our sponsors, Dicehead, but Dicehead's online store is down right now. They're doing a restructure. Just PM me out. Like, literally, if you're interested in figuring out how to get better discounts, PM me on Facebook. I'm not gonna like broadcast it live over there. Oh, Karn, we're doing a dick measuring competition now? Painting professionally for 12 years? Alright, you win. GW gloss wash is garbage. Mix your own washes. That's how you do it. What Ty Winning said. My figs, my FLGS gives no fucks with the 40K community. It's all magic. See, they had to go magic because they didn't have the fucking foresight to understand the Wargaming discount requirement. So every FLGS has to go magic, Star City, fucking matched trade-in systems, and they have to deal in the crack cocaine that is CCGs. That's what's up, you know? Reg SSS6, have you already paint a Tyranids? If yes, can see example, please. Ironheaded, can you track down a couple links on my, hold on a second. What am I doing? How do I make someone a moderator? I think I know how to do it. Did I do it? Is that how you do it? I don't think I did it. Someone remind me how to make someone a moderator. Ironheaded, obviously you're a moderator. I don't know why I haven't made you one yet. I'm tired of having him post back links for me to post when he can just do them. I'm looking it up. How do you make a moderator? Does anyone know? My Twitch Kung Fu is so weak. I look like I know what I'm doing, but that's only because I had so much help. Moderation. God. How many moderators should I? I don't care about this. Why is it not like, how do you make a moderator? How come there's literally like, it's all like, what do moderators do? How many moderators should I? What the fuck is this? Someone figure out how to make moderators for me. The British Pete's hilarious. All right. Watching a video with no sound. Why is this video so dumb? Watching this video, this guy's taking forever to tell me. Did it. Ironheaded, you now have the power to post links, I believe. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Since he's always on lock, please post some, see if you can track down some of those Tyranid, like, Carnifex videos I had on YouTube a while back. Maybe that'll help. Oh, Karn, you're going to backpedal now, talking about how you got to paint thousands of miniatures and they got to look just tabletop? All right. That's the battle we're going to be in? Playing with you, Karn. But seriously. Gloss wash. Ironheaded, do not slap Nightbot. This is not, I'm not giving you permission to use all caps all the time. But Karn, do you have a Facebook page or anything with your service and everything? All joking aside, I like to pimp out all people. All right, let's get back to painting, guys. I've had my cup. I feel better about my life now. Let's get in these cracks. Getting more ambitious with the cracks as I go. And what's cool is, like, the gloss wash breaks the surface tension so much, like, I missed a couple of these cracks, and then it just flowed right back into the crack and didn't leave any behind on the surface. Just like that. You see, as my confidence grows with the technique, I'm just getting faster and faster. Let's go up to the top skull. There it is. Let's get in these teethers. Just like that. Let's get this other crack. Just like so. Looks like we got something fun down here to play with. And this crack keeps extending. Get down these teethers right here. Just like that. Be careful not to undo any of these washes I just did as I flip it over. Real easy stuff. And this is the last skull. Pretty much done with skulls after this. I said, you can get ambitious. Let it flow. Let it. Let gravity do it. There it is. He's getting his teeth. Got a little wash speckling, and I just wiped it off because the gloss wash takes forever to dry too. Let's make sure we have the transition cracks where they connect the skulls. Missed a big seam right here. Right there it is. Okay, so I'm feeling pretty good about that. We'll pour some of this wash back in my little pot. I'm gonna show it off a little bit here. Fun little tower of skulls. And I'll show you like what we have what for the top. So what we have on the top piece is I just dropped one of these deals. Got a couple of like fun, I don't know, griffin statues here, and a big chair for a dude to sit in here. So we'll paint all these like gold and shiny as fucking awesome on top. And now I'm definitely thinking we gotta paint the brick dark green Castle Grayskull throwback. I'm feeling like that's the situation. Let me go back and make sure Ironhead is not abusing things. Yeah, how you like me now? Don't fuck this down. Ruthless, wow. Do you want to get the teeth back the fuck out? Want to get on it like that? Well, then shout. Javier came in with a clutch donation trying to trigger a John Cena gif. And he actually triggered one of our new Thug Life gifts. Sorry, Javier. You had to get you were the first one to trigger that, though. But I appreciate the donation. Hold on a second. I want to see this. This chat theory. Suplex City on Nightbot. Karn, someone was asking about being inexpensive. What to do with the historical painting? Horde painting. I actually have a video on horde painting. You're probably right up your alley. Ironhead, find that video I did on painting those zombies, painting hordes. It's a pretty good, you get a really high quality result for very little effort. It's if you haven't seen the video. $90 barbarians. $450 a dude. Now like, I'm not gonna tell anyone how to charge. That's really low. Now if you have a market that won't pay you more than that, I understand. You know what I'm saying? Just make sure you're putting $450 a dude in, though. You know what I'm saying? Don't blow it up. But inversely, if you raise the quality, you raise the demand for a little while at the same prices, then you can charge more. Once you have demand, you have a long queue, then you can start charging what you're worth. Because even with your ghetto techniques of banging out, you know, 90 barbarians, getting them on a tabletop for the community that you're in, even at $4.50 a model, guarantee, you know, you're still making shitty wages, you know? So you always got to think about that. I mean, that's the problem. Artists don't like to think like businessmen, but, like, that's the business. If you can build a long queue of clients who want your stuff because you've crept the quality up for the same price, then you can demand more money. Yeah, Ty, when Ironhead is back there laughing and twisting his mustache. You have the power. The British Pete. He said something funny. Gotta get in the crack. It's true. Ironhead, not a lot of people ask me for freehand designs. I just do them for free and just sneak them in on commissions to make my clients happy, thus creating the demand, slipping the higher quality in for the price. Gotta get them hooked. It's like crack, man. The first time you smoke crack, remember that moment? Like, that's basically what I try to do with a client, give them that free crack on top of the commission, hook them for life. Yeah, the runes on those space walls, I just snuck them in. I didn't charge for them. Jazar, I need to get me some Randy Savage gifts. Still one more name checking in. Kind of the tail end of our broadcast. Anyone doesn't know? Going to be kicking it with Still One More Name by 5 today. We're gonna get iced, and we're going to film a West Coast Guerrilla Battle Report together. We've been doing this since 11 a.m. Still One More Name. Yo, the skull's looking good, right, Dalen? Dalen? Oh, you know what? I don't do decals, though, Ironhead. That's fun that you mentioned that. I don't make them. I don't do them. I can't make them look good. I'm never happy with them. Because, like, I'm such an extreme airbrush artist with such crisp and, like, sick transitions. I have never been able to make a decal interact with my airbrushing in a way that makes me happy. I don't offer them. I say, you can put them on yourself when you get it. But if you really want some unit identification, like, we'll bang out some icons or whatever. But, you know, like, if they ask for the decals, then I'll try to sell them freehand. Super loud. Does anybody else think I'm super way too loud? I think these are the settings I typically use. I'll turn the sensitivity down. That's true. The historical game market has a lot of China people barely charging. Trezar. Yeah, no, I'll opt to get a better setup to do the detail work, because right now it's hard for me to paint that detail on camera because just like the overextending of my limbs and not getting that like that solid base. I definitely will, though. Well, Karn, that's an impressive 6-7 hours to get 90 guys done. Can't complain. My Twitter. Do I not have Twitter as a command? Yeah, I think it's YoDog or YoDog _ Kenny. Can you confirm that, Ironheaded? I'm not as interactive on my Twitter as I'd like to be, but I am somewhat active. I'll show you guys the box art. I think I have the box art laying around. It's called Mage Wrath Throne and Balewind Vortex. I think it's out of print. Let's see if I can get the box art up on deck. Get the light down so you guys can see it. No, try to get that glare out. So here's the vortex that the dude stands on. Get the crotch cam going. You can see the dais up there where the dude chills. This is kind of like the inspiration. So you see, like, we went kind of similar, but we went a little bit more extreme than they went with the skulls. And I always like to do things a little different. But we're going to do our bricks green, as suggested. But yeah, and we'll paint that vortex on camera here. Promise, I won't do you guys dirty and not paint, not airbrush the fuck out of this. Get some sick ass OSL on this thing, you know. We did the green stuff seam today too, guys. Showed you some green stuff seam coverage. But I'm gonna Q&A write it out for the rest of the episode. Then I gotta get ready for my trip to see Still One More Name. Ask away, guys. I don't think British people are too thug life these days. They're so nice and drink so much tea. Karn, what's up there? What'd you say? quick shout out to my boy, Still One More Name, checking in. Quick roll call to my donators today. Javier, triggering the new gift, the new Thug Life gift. Jazar came in hot. Joe Darkblade, first time. Warchild. Oh, sorry, Warchild was from last night. I also appreciate that. A. Martin came in fresh today. Daylin 007, just picked up my first 40k models in a while. Getting back into it with some Chaos, Space Marines, and Demon King Kenny. How can I hashtag make Chaos great again? Psh. Lots of ways, bro. I win lots of events with Chaos. Space Marines is my primary. The list I run right now is 1850 is basically, I'm going to say, it's less than 300 points, or roughly 300 points of Demon Ally, and like 1500 points of Chaos Space Marines. I've got videos of me winning tournaments, beating two Eldar players in a row, triple cat Eldar and stuff. Like, they can be done. But the number one way to make Chaos great, Chaos Space Marines specifically, is psychic powers. You gotta play the psychic game. They have an amazing level 3 psyker with a spell familiar. Let you reroll the psychics. Like, that's an amazing tool you got to use, especially now that the Cyclopia Cabal is a real thing. That lets you bring in like three sorcerers in a formation that really help you get the powers you want. Now, obviously, I played a lot of armies with Chaos where I have like all these units that are like less than 180 points, like Nurgle Spawn, Maul of Fiends, and etc. And if you run those sorcerers all over the place, you're like, yo, we're shrouded, we're invisible. Endurance, you can make like Nurgle Spawn super hard to interact with, and you can bring Bellicor in for the auto invisibility. If you play ITC though, that's not 350 points for a guy who just does invisibility, who can basically not land safely in front of a Tau army. It's not the way to go. But I've got a really fresh army right now with Crimson Slaughter, Cyclopia Cabal, and Chaos Allies, where I'm using a Khorne Spawn Star with a Khorne Lord on Juggernaut from Crimson Slaughter with the Demon Heart, Power of His Lightning Claw, as the anchor, Cyclopean Cabal with like three sorcerers attached, and a Bale Star of Marmon Psyker attached. So I have like this psychic protocol where I can roll my dice, make that Spawn Star immune to damage, get across the table, fuck people up, and bring in a couple of Bloodthirsters, like with Possession, which is why we did that video on eBay hacks to get some Bloodthirsters. half the time I'm getting two bloodthirsters for free, you know? So there's a lot of ways to play Chaos Exciting. Drizzar, Thousand Suns. There's actually some ways to play a Thousand Suns. Aramon is a beast. Level 4 Psyker. He's, you know, he'll catch people slipping. But my favorite part about Aramon is his Warlord trait, Master of Deceit, or Master of Deception. D3 infantry units in your army can infiltrate. Last time I checked, a block of 20,000 Submarines with AP3 Bolters infiltrating and getting into rapid fire range on turn 1, that's a problem. Especially if you're down to make sure you take Zinch allies. You know what I'm saying? Get them Zinch allies in there. Get another Herald with a Paradox Cube to help you generate new units every turn on 5 dice. And I recommend trying to get some Eldrakes in the list. Eldrakes are just too good now with the new agility moves, where basically they can like vector strike something, agility, and still flame. They're pretty good. Basically, like what Ironheaded said. Zinch Herald with Paradox, level 3, and 11 Horrors in a bunker. My favorite thing. Get a bunker, Peril Bunker with an escape hatch. Put the bunker right on, like 3 inches away from the objective. Put the escape hatch where you think you might need a Bloodthirster to possess, you know? And roll up your powers. Roll all 3 on Demonology. See if you get a lucky 6. If you don't, no big deal. You just pop him out behind the hatch and just start throwing units of demons forward into position. And you only need 5 dice to guarantee a summon with the Paradox. So if you have like 3 from him, 2 for the Horrors, 4 from Aramon, literally that's a free unit every turn. People can't stop it. You get Aramon infiltrated into range. Aramon's like, you know, can literally say Psychic Shriek 4 times in a row. Like if you have the power for that. So he can like literally take down 3 Flying Hive Tyrants. Like, so there's some sick tech. Also another cool thing, Zinch. Cultists on a Sky Shield landing pad with Aramon, they have 3 up invulnerables from shooting attacks, and he can just start shooting people. Dumba, don't worry, we're going to repost this video ad-free on Patreon and then with ads on YouTube, so you'll be able to catch back up. That's good to hear, Karn, doing some 30k airbrushing. Like I said, guys, I'm going to do about 5 more minutes of Q&A, then I'm going to shut it down, get the videos exported, get ready, go do my Guerrilla Battle Report with my boy, still one more name. So about 1:45, I'm going to shut this joint down. So if you got any questions about it, anything, I'll answer them as they come in. Drazar says, well, that settles it. After my Crimson Fist is done, I'm remaking my Thousand Suns. Thanks, Karn. Try to do my best on stream. Synth the 47, what range do you have experience with? Vallejo, GW, P3, those are my favorite ranges. I've got colors I like from all those ranges, but like Vallejo has some of the best pigments for game color. Their metallic airbrush line is literally second to none. They have really good washes. P3 has some amazing pigments I like too, like the greens. GW has the tentacle game unlock. Like, you can't fuck with GW. Oh, British Pete, don't forget the press up push up challenge. Are you, oh, I know who you are. Is this your first time jumping in finally? Yep, you're Facebooking me right now. Nice glass, nearly gone. Picture in picture, watching the stream. My boy Peter. Yep. Apparently I have to do, 20 push-ups a day for 20 days or some shit? Ooh, Ty Winden, you have a Thousand Suns 30k army? I would never take more than one unit of Thousand Sun Marines just to say it's Thousand Suns. Too expensive. That's why I like the block of 20 with that infiltrate because of Mr. Aramon. Another cool tech with Aramon is unit of Zeem's Terminators and a Land Raider with plasma, combi plasma. Land Raider dedicated transport, they also get to infiltrate if you it's D3 units. So if you roll a 2, or you know, like you roll the average of 2 units, you can also infiltrate a Land Raider. Karn, I do like Reaper. I use my favorite 2 colors from Reaper are the Master Series Harvest Brown and Orange Brown. And also like their new gold color. Like, but Reaper makes some amazing paints. I just don't use them as often. Antique Gold's another one they have that's amazing. Chef G checking in. Kind of late, bro. We started at 11 a.m. today. I tried to promote it. We're about to be out of here in just a few minutes. But thanks for checking in. I'll repost it on Patreon and YouTube today. Zeem Spikers, they suck, bro. Like, the best Spikers are Slaanesh Spikers. And I have some good Slaanesh lists. I shared one with Absinthe recently. Slaanesh Spikers are Toughness 5, and they get the Feel No Pain banner. That's the best combo for a bike unit. Like, you get the most survivability. Kalth, the Betrayal of Kalth. Also, cool news, like, going into, not for August, but for the next month, anybody on my Patreon page who's doing the monthly like retail support, like the subscription box, we're going to be doing Betrayal of Kalth minis for that next month. About a minute more before I call it quits, guys. Any last minute questions? Let me know. Anybody hasn't checked out the new Bloodthirster video on Patreon, eBay hacks, how to take a model you bought on eBay and hacking it to tabletop quality in a few simple steps. Check it out. Drizzar, the Longword dice bags are in the Fayetteville Beats Lab. Rob has the bags. Now he just has to break down the bits and put them in the bags. We are a little bit behind, but we have it. Like, it's happening. Don't worry. Everything we do, anytime we do like a little push, it's we have to like do pre-sales. Like, we don't have the product in hand. We have to take the money we raise to buy the product. Good news is we have all the dice bags. We have all the bits. We just have to get Juice in the Beats Lab to do the manual labor and put them on and print up the labels and ship them. Happening real soon. Karn. Oh, Dick Blick. The black mat is good. Cool. I'll try that out. John Bingham, thanks for tuning in. Yep, we're going to be beasting out of here. Drizzar says I'm moving in a month. How would I get you guys my new address? Send an email to the Long War. That's Long War. That's 40klongwar@gmail.com. Send it in as soon as you know it. And also make sure you have a change of address form done as soon as possible, just in case the worst should happen. Cheesy Poops, I appreciate it. Doing my best. Alright, guys. Been real kicking it with you guys. I love hanging out with you guys on Twitch. We have a sick community. Roll call to all my supporters one more time. Joe, Darkblade, Javier, A. Martin checking in. And I think we have one more. Javier, Jazar. There we go, Jazar. Thank you guys for donations. We're doing clutch work. Appreciate it. Everybody else, check out the YouTube page. Check out Twitter. Check out Facebook. Check out Patreon, man. Appreciate it. Play on, players.